What's up, everybody? It's me, Nicholas. Today we are here with another video. This is a reaction. Well, I'm not going to say reaction because this is a commentary. And I will be commenting on our favorite YouTuber that we love to talk about now. That seems like, as much as they want to talk about staying out of drama, they can't stay out of it to save their lives. That's right, we're talking about Trisha Paytas. So, with that, I wanted to voice my opinion on what she said about what happened, unfortunately, in Texas, and it's now gonna be 2 weeks, and so, yeah. If you haven't already, if you can give me a subscribe, that would be great. That would be greatly appreciated. I'd appreciate that if you guys did that for me. I'm at 122 subscribers. I'd ideally like to get by 150, hopefully by the end of this month, you know, next month. It would be a great thing for Pride for me. So if you guys could do that for me, that would be great. Anyway, though, let's get into this. Because I've got a lot to say on what she has said.
Hey everyone, I'm in my daughter's nursery. It's being painted right now and reworked. And I set up a little cushion spot in here to kind of like work in. Just have a little spot in here while there's work being done.
I'm also going to add captions so that way I can actually understand what she's saying. Now I know the captions aren't word for word or they're not correct. But for anybody that can't hear the video, I'm going to put these captions on and then I'm going to comment because there's a lot to break down here.
In our bedroom and other parts of the house. excuse me. I wanted to talk about like something really, like, I guess I don't really get like, look. I did a tweet Sunday that obviously people were upset about, saying like, you know, I don't really, basically I don't like to hear about politics. And I said, it's probably because I'm ignorant and I just don't want to learn about it because it makes me like so depressed. And obviously it was taken as like, well, you're privileged. That's why it doesn't affect you. And your privilege is talking and your kids will suffer because of you. Something, you know, all along those lines, and I understand that. I totally understand that. I was just kind of just being honest and being like, if there's other people like me out there, like, you're not.
Okay, so I respect that part, Trisha, and, like, that's fine. And, you know, for me, I try as much as politically active and outspoken as I am as a person. I don't really speak on it that much or get into it, or else it just emotionally drains me. So I understand that part, but I don't think it's necessarily appropriate to like mention that. You know, in a way it's good that you don't want to, you know, get into that, but you don't want to make it out to be like, well, like I don't want to seem ignorant, but I choose not to listen to politics, which is fine, and everything. But you're gonna see what's wrong in this video and why this is still very, you know, in a way she knew what she was doing when she made this video, when she put it out there, and to anybody, you know, again, I'm gonna be linking this down in my channel. I'm gonna be putting up links so that way you guys can kind of help out and even find out what happened, because this is just a terrible tragedy. Unfortunately, this won't end, all these mass shootings, especially these school shootings, but there have been 19 lives taken, unfortunately, by a gunman down in Ulvade, Texas, and basically he shot up a elementary school, and unfortunately, there have been back-to-back funerals all week within that town. And, it's just a terrible tragedy, but, you're gonna see why I completely, like, this is the worst type of video ever to put out. Second of all, like, we're gonna talk about this because this is really, this is not, like, if you're at least trying to address the public school system, if you're trying to at least somewhat give your take on what happened on an event, this is the, like, I could even have a 5-year-old come up here and grade you, and you'd probably fail because of your response. This is, like, this is beyond tone deaf. This is beyond, you know, this is all entitled behavior, but we can see, there's literally a freaking pattern with Trisha Paytas, and, you know, it's nothing, you know, I'm calling it out, but this is nothing new, and I'm pretty sure she's going to continue to do this, and as she's also having a child, because I'm bringing up the fact that she has a child, and she's now bringing this up, this is pretty, just sit with me with a video.
Not alone, because I sometimes feel so stupid when it comes to politics, but I also feel like so helpless, because then the stuff I do know, it's like, well, what can be done about it? And like, there's just not a lot. Obviously voting and getting educated and stuff like that, obviously, and all that. Anyways, I know it's gonna make people mad. Once again, I'm really ignorant to this stuff. I
did you see this? Oh, sorry guys. Did you hear that? She didn't want to get into politics because it makes her depressed and anxious. But now she's saying, once again, I choose to be ignorant to this stuff. Like, even the subtitles don't get it, but you can literally, we're going back to the minute and 16 mark. We're going to really listen to this again.
Obviously, voting and getting educated and stuff like that, obviously, and all that. Anyways, I know it's going to make people mad. Once again, I'm really ignorant to this stuff. I choose to be ignorant to it, and I...
Right there. Oh my freaking, like, the contradictions, like, you're not even 2 minutes into the video, and you're already contradicting yourself, as well as just, you know what, I choose to... And the thing is, though, this is not new behavior for Trisha, and if I really wanted to, I could go back a few decades onto her channel and kind of like, I don't think she has those videos up, or if she took them down, but if she did, then like, I mean, you lost a lot of like views and everything, which is crazy, but it kind of also shows Trisha's true colors. So
yeah, you know, I understand when people say like that's a privilege too. It's just,
and that is privileged behavior, like, the fact that you literally just admitted, and it, like, there are two, okay, there are two sides of the coin. There's one that, hey, I don't want to get in politics because it might, you know, emotionally drain me, and that's fine. Then there's the other side, you know, of like, alright, well, I know what politics is. I'm choosing to be ignorant and choosing to be blind by this, so you know what? You know, I'm not gonna vote or everything, and because I feel like I'm entitled, if I'm living here, I'm just, you know, free land and everything, like, or I shouldn't do my part as American, at least try to be aware of what's going on in my country and what things I should be informed about. And, like, again, it's like, when you choose, like, and you literally admitted saying, I choose to be ignorant, that paints a very nasty picture on you as, you know, as someone of, you know, that paints a really bad picture on you as a human being, because you're choosing to be ignorant, so that means you're invalidating necessarily, you know, you're validating a lot of things, and it's just... It's nothing new on Trisha's part, like, we've all seen on the internet, but it just puts a horrible taste in everybody's mouth.
There's something that's been so plaguing America, and this is, like, another thing where it's, like, I guess I should just know politics better or know how to handle this, but I feel like no one knows how to handle this because there's no solution, and that is school shootings, mass shootings. I've always been terrified of mass shootings, like...
That's one thing, like, literally, there is nothing being done for teachers, and there are nothing being done to protect a lot of, you know, a lot of like, anybody who's, you know, from preschool all the way to, like, even university, there's nothing done. Like, all these shooting lockdowns that are, you know, supposedly supposed to protect us, it's nothing. Like, I've even had to be in, you know, unfortunately, there was someone who had a gun on our campus and was trying to get into the school because they had something going on internally that I don't want to say, you know, any, like, it probably is, like, they had a, you know, some type of episode, whatever. We were lucky enough to, like, live within the police precinct to have a officer not, to have an office not too far from us that could arrive there within minutes. So we were lucky that we were able to, like, have the person, like, you know, apprehended, but they were, like, starting to yank at the doors and everything, and the security guards were very they're like, crap, like, and the thing is, I come from a Chicago public school, so even if, like, say, security guards, you know, were to be armed, they can't, necessarily, because it looks bad on their behalf, but also, unfortunately, there are some children within those schools that do really bad things and hang out with bad groups. I don't think I could say the G word, but they do that, and they might be armed. Even though we're not allowed to have weapons in the school, there are certain schools that don't do security checks, and I think now it's different. Like, the thing is, you can't have any type of weapon, but the problem, though, is that they do random searches, so anybody can bring a weapon and you wouldn't even know it until it's too late. And that's happened within the Chicago Public Schools, but I think it was junior year, but basically, like, some guy around, you know, was, but anyway, though, like, yeah, America literally hasn't done anything, and they're probably not going to do anything about these mass shootings, even though, like, 6:30, Biden gave, like, a speech on it, but that's not going to help. Like, addressing the issue doesn't help, and we're now in, like, it's bad. And, like, I agree with Trish on that. Like, the country's done nothing for, you know, what's it called, for all these mass shootings. Like, and I don't want to get into arm control or, like, gun control or anything, but I do agree with her, like, what she's saying right now, not with everything that she's saying, but, again, like, at least that's one thing that we can have at least, we both agree on.
Since I was a kid, when I was in elementary school, Columbine was like, the biggest thing. It was, like, 1999 or something, so I was, like, 11, I was, like, in middle school. I was terrified of school shootings. There seemed to be a lot of those. Obviously, Columbine was, like, the first big one that got news, but then right after that was, like, the Virginia Tech shootings, and then there was all those shootings in the movie theater, and later on, obviously, as an adult, you know, I remember Christina Grimmie at her show, and then the next day, the Pulse nightclub shootings in Orlando. There's even been mass shootings close to where I lived, in LA, and
like, I know exactly what shooting she's talking about, too. It's the San Bernardino, which is, like, that's probably, like, 20, 30 minutes out from where Trish was located, but, I mean, at least she's, like, she's at least hitting 40% of this video, but.
And just at casual places, or Sandy Hook Elementary School, that was around the same time as, like, Columbine, and it just seems to be happening Buffalo, New York. You know, I see this stuff. Like I said, I don't, obviously I'm not seeking it out. I'm not watching news outlets or anything, but I see it on Twitter and stuff like that. And I see it all over TikTok. I see, you know, it does kind of smack you in the face with it. And it's something that just, like, it devastates me. It truly crushes me. So it's not that I don't care. It's like, what can be done? And it's, like, second to the tragedy of everyone, the people that lost their lives. It's, like, is the fact that there's no solution. There's no, Like, what are we doing to fix this? And there's just absolutely nothing. And I see people talk about, you know, ban all guns and, you know, anti-gun laws, and then combats with people. Well, people are going to find the guns whether they're legal or not. I'm not, again, I'm not on either side of it. I don't know. I don't know the answer. If it stopped mass shootings, I would say ban all guns. Yes. But like people say, like, people will just find those guns, and like the wrong people have the guns, and the people who are on the right side of things won't have access to guns, and then it's a really bad situation. So I don't know the answer to that. And that's why politics in general, just, there's no win. There's no answer. And I don't understand.
Skip ahead.
I have my own issues with public, well, I just hate public school, but on one hand,
we're getting into it right now. So- All right. She's talking about why she won't send her daughter to a public school. And again, it doesn't make a difference. These can happen anywhere, Trisha. But the thing is, though, you're dissing the public school systems now after this tragedy that happened in a public school. And, like, this really paints a horrible picture on you. But also, this is quite damaging. Like, you don't know, like, how bad it like, it's bad. But the fact that, like, the thing is, Trisha won't understand because she hasn't necessarily been, like, again, this is the privilege thing in a way. Like, she hasn't really lived that experience. Like, you know, she's white. Okay, like, you know, you're lucky enough to be, you know, at least, you know, in, you know, a school system that, you know, or I don't know, like, how you, like, or anything, but, like, it's just, like, the fact that, I guess, you don't necessarily, you haven't, you know, been where I was at. You know, I was adopted by two white parents. Me and my sibling, you know, are both black, and, you know, and then I also have a sister, too, but we've been bounced from public school to Catholic private school, and, like, we've had different experiences there. I would say that overall, I had a better experience at a private school. However, I had more support from the public school system as far as my education goes. And, you know, they at least somewhat launched me to where, you know, I'm, you know, in a way I'm starting to become more independent. Granted that my private school educations that I've had in the past, yes, it was more structured. They had way more emphasis on studying, and, you know, and there were more people, you know, of class there. But the thing is, though, they didn't have as much support for my learning disability. They didn't have support, you know, for my autism. Now, my public school, like, the magnet school that I did go to for the rest of high school year and everything, you know, they had support for, you know, me being, you know, in one-on-one classroom. They had more tutoring access. Now, I was bullied. That's, you know, I was bullied in both settings. I really didn't have a choice. However, though, when I did come out as trans, you know, they were respectful, and, you know, they asked me about, you know, they had questions, which is great. Like, and at a private school setting, normally that's not, you know, you're closeted pretty much. And if you were to come out, then you have, like, and the thing is, again, you know, I'm not, you know, not saying that you would be, you know, like, at the end of the day, this can happen anywhere, but the fact that you then bring this in to, this is still, you know, even though it's been 2 weeks since, now 2 weeks passing, this is still fresh in everybody's mind. Everybody's going through the motions, especially the families that have lost their daughter, son, brother, grandchild, you know, niece, nephew. And, you know, and they happen to be friends with, you know, family that is grieving, or they also lost their fellow friend. And then you also have the surviving kids, now very traumatized. They will never, ever get this out of their mind. So the fact that then, you know, Like, and the shocking thing is, though, I guess what upsets me is that really she didn't, what's it called? Again, you monetize off of this stuff, so whatever you're making on this video, and however many views that you've gotten, this will all go to her family channel, and they will profit off of this. And so there wasn't really any, you know, there wasn't any links that, or, like, she didn't share about, you know, this is how you can help, you know, this is how you can donate, you know. If I, you know, and if she even made, you know, if she had a sponsorship or if she had something, which I haven't really seen on her channels anymore, which I think that there's a clear reason why. But whatever you're making on this video that you put up, that's going to your pocket. And, like, I'm even looking on here, like, I don't know if there's any links or not. No, there's not even a link. But, like, and even the comments, too, and I know I commented on, crap, I can't find my comment. Oh, or do I click on, I'm going to read the comments section because I feel like the video is making me more upset. Jeez. I'm going to do news first because, okay. Alright. And this looks like, oh my goodness, that's sad. Okay. Okay, so the comment from this person says, I was made attention to her video. I live in Texas, and you making this video within hours of our students and two teachers laid dying is sick and disrespectful to these families who've lost their lives. I will report this video to YouTube to get it taken down. Don't ever talk about other families or shootings that you know nothing about. And I completely agree with this, like, this person's anger is valid. And then there are other, and then this guy says, these comments are absurd. She has every, okay, this looks like a Trisha stan. Okay, here's another one. Alright, here's one that I completely agree with. What's it called? Alright. It's so ironic how there was a whole school shooting and 21 people are dead and hundreds are mourning the loss of their families, and Trisha has to make this whole situation about herself. Like, people died, no one cares about whatever you think is best for your child. She's truly disgusted and needs to be taken off the internet. It's disgusting how she's making money by talking about this tragic situation. She needs to be canceled. At this point, I feel like, to me, Trisha's been canceled. She's been canceled ever since. And, like, if you guys don't know this form, go on Reddit, type in Trishy Land. It's Trishy. So, Trishy and then Land. And, basically, it's a whole form, basically, dedicated to literally, we're spilling the receipts. Like, whatever she's doing, like, and here's the sad part. She's now months pregnant, like, and she recently posted up, like, videos of, you know, her and her daughter, and then she also has her live streams as well. But it's like, you're still on OnlyFans, and, you know, again, I don't want to comment on people's money situation, but it's like, if I were pregnant, and then after, you know, I have my baby, there are still fans of your OLF page that are going to be wondering where you are. And there are some that are already not in. And, like, the thing is, too, if you check her OnlyFans page, it's not as popping as it was months prior. I don't go on OnlyFans because I did make an account just for laughs. I haven't posted anything on it yet. I'm a little afraid to, but I'm probably not. I forgot, like, my password and everything, so... so I'm not really worried about going back on. But it's like, you have your kid in the mix. After that, then, you know, like, this is all literally to benefit her. This is not to, like, help the families. So, at least, I'm gonna do damage. I shouldn't say this, but I'm probably gonna have to do damage control. I'm doing it not only to help, you know, the families that are still mourning their loss, but it's like, there's a whole freaking community that needs to heal. So, I know I'm not as big as I am now. However, if you can share this video, get it to so many views, and if you can, donate to, you know, the links that I have below to help some of these families pay for expenses or just to get them by, during this time, because this is, like, still very raw, this is very emotional, we're all gonna remember this is, and it's not. And I like this comment. You're not ignorant, but you do choose to be. And there are also a mix of Trisha stans. Overall, this situation just with Trisha, it's just very messy, and this clearly, like, this did not make anything better. So, with that, this is going to be the end of the video. Thank you guys so much for watching this. I appreciate you guys. I appreciate every one of you that views my videos, that returns. It's been great. And I will see you in the next one.
Step one, wake up, really gonna rise with the sun. Step two, get some good, some food in you. Step three, think real hard about what you wanna be. Step four, fuck everybody, just do your thing.
Wake up, today's gonna be a good day. Wake up. 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 Today's gonna be a good day.